This is a gambling simulator run on an Excel spreadsheet. You start with a bankroll of $500 and bet $1 at a time. And each time I press the F9 key, the simulator generates 400 coin flips, and the graph shows you what happens to your money. If I press this a few times, you'll see that generally you end up somewhere close to where you started with. The red line shows the results of gambling with roulette, and the blue line shows the results gambling with a fair coin flip game. I'll show you how to set this up, starting with a blank spreadsheet. I'll start by putting some labels here. This is via the random data column. This will be the bankroll. And this will be the win-lose amount. To make the random number, you type this, equals, R-A-N-D, left, right. That's the random number generator. You see there's a random number there. I can copy this. And it generates a different random number for each instance. And each time I press the F9 key or make an entry anywhere in the table, it generates a new random sequence. Let's start with a bankroll of $500. Now this will be the win-lose amount. It's a function, a logical function. I'll type equals if left parentheses, and there you can see the function logical test, value of true, value of false. So I'll say if the value in this cell, the random number, is less than 0.5, less than 1/2, then you win, and that's a plus 1. Otherwise, you lose, that's a negative 1. Okay, so that's the function. Press enter. So whenever this number is less than 0.5, you get a 1 here, and whenever it's greater than 0.5, you get a negative 1. So let's copy this function over. You can see that this is greater than 0.5, you get a negative 1. Now, how does the bankroll change? Each time you win or lose, you need to add or subtract, or actually just add this win or lose value, whether it's negative or positive. So for after the first flip, it's the value of the bankroll is equal to the previous bankroll value, which is right above, plus this kitty corner value over here. I press enter. So you can see the bankroll went up by 1 because that was a win. Now let's copy the same function over. Now each time there's a negative 1, this bankroll goes down by 1. Each time there's a positive 1, the bankroll goes up. Now I'd like to repeat this not just 16 or times, but 400 times. So if I click here to select, hold down the shift key and click here, I've selected this whole row here. There's the little green dot. I drag downward until I reach 403. That would be 400 trials. So we started from row 2, 403. Okay, scroll back up. Now I'd like to graph this change in bankroll. So let me first select the whole stack from row 2. I'll click there to select this one. Scroll down to the end. Hold down the shift key and press select and click. That is, hold down shift and click. Now I can insert a graph of that. So I'll do insert, charts. I see a variety of charts. I'll choose this one here. And I'll go down and click the OK button. And there's our chart of 400 coin flip results. I'll change the chart title to bankroll. Bankroll. I'd like this line to be thinner. Select this line, right click, outline, weight. Here we go. 3/4 point, 1 point. Let me try pressing the F9 key a few times. You can see each time I press F9, it generates a new sequence. Here you have a long winning streak from $510 to $530. I would like to show this starting line as black. I don't know the simple way to do it, so I'll do it the hard way. Start from here, and I'll just enter the value equals 500. Select it, go to the little dot, drag down, and make a sequence of 400 of the 500s. And I'll graph that. Okay. I'll right-click this, choose Select Data, click Add, Series Name, I'll call it 500, and the values will be here. From here, all the way to the end, Shift, click, press Enter here, and there's the line. I'll click OK. OK. Now I don't want this brown. I want it to be black. So I'll make it black. And I will make it thin. Weight, 3/4 point. All right. There's our graph. Now when I press F9, it automatically adjusts the scale to fit the data. I'd like to have a fixed scale instead of always adjusting automatically. So I'm going to click here on the left scale. And I'll right click that and say format axis. I like to go from always from 440 to 560. Okay, close this. And I can press F9 any number of times here and show a different 400 coin flip sequence. Now the way I've drawn this, set this up with these lines at intervals of 20, this represents one standard deviation for 400 coin flips. So that means after you've done this, the amount of capital you'll have at the end has a 2/3 chance of ending up between these two lines, the two closest lines, somewhere in between, 2/3 chance. Between the next set of lines from between here and here, it has a 95% chance, or 19 out of 20 times it should end up between these two lines. And then these outermost lines should almost always end up between them. Let's see if that's true. So I'll just press F9 a bunch of times. Yeah, it's outside of that inner zone, so we expect it to fall outside that zone about 1/3 of the time, and it's about right. And there was one, that last one went out here, outside of the more than two lines away. That should happen about once every 20 times. Okay, this is for a fair coin flip game. Let's look at the result for an unfair game like roulette. We'll have a different, we'll do the same kind of thing. Bankroll here. We'll start with a bankroll of 500. Win, lose, And we'll enter the formula here, equals this random number. No, we need the if function. If, left parentheses, logical test, this number less than, instead of last time we did 0.5, but this time we'll put the probability of say winning a red on a roulette wheel is there are 18 red, there are 18 red slots out of a total of 38. So the chance of getting red is 18/38. So if the random number is less than 18/38, that's a win. Otherwise, it's a lose. Okay. Once again, that formula is if the random number is less than 18/38, you win. Otherwise, you lose. Let's copy this. Oh, and then the bankroll, of course, is equal to your previous bankroll plus the value kitty corner, the win or lose value here. Enter. So now I can pull this down. There's loss, it's 499, there's followed by a win. I can copy this, click here to select, hold down shift, select this, drag down to 403 or whatever it was. The more I pull down, the faster it drags. Okay, 403. Okay, now we need to add that plot. So if I right-click on this graph, select data, add another line, series name, I'll call it red, and what will it contain? It will contain all the values in this bankroll from here. I click there to select, scroll down to the bottom, hold down shift, click here, select that whole column, and there it is, sheet 1 from F2 to F403. Press enter, click OK again, and there it is. I will change the color to red. I select it, right click, change the color to red, and change the weight to 3/4 point. Okay, there's our graph. And you can see that I'm going to make this a little bigger. That's a little too big. I want to be able to fit it in here. Okay, now I can press F9, and you can see that playing roulette is worse than a fair game. On the average, you lose about 20 bets or so more than in 400 bets, you lose about 20 more than you do with a fair game. Okay, well, let's see what happens. Instead of betting on red, let's say you bet on a number. Say you're playing roulette, you bet on number 7. What does that look like? We'll change this one. The win or lose, we'll say instead of 18/38, put 1/38. That's the probability of hitting your lucky number 7 or whatever. If you win, it pays 35/1. So I'll put a 35 here. If it loses, you lose 1. Press enter. Okay, I've only changed the formula in this cell. I need to copy that to all the other cells. So I'll select it. This has still got the old formula. Take the new formula. Go to the little dot, drag downward to 403. Okay. This is much more volatile because when you hit that 35/1, you can go off the screen. This is what we've done. So let's change this, the range here on the left side. I'll select the vertical axis, format axis. Instead of from 445.60, I'm going to go from 0 to 1,000. Okay. Now we got some interesting results. You got a nice big win here. Let's see what happens if we press F9 a few times. That's a pretty bad losing streak. You lost down from $500 to $300 because of these a fairly long losing streak. On average, you hit this about 10 times. You hit your lucky number about 10 times in 400 trials. Let's look at a few more. Okay. In the next video, I'll do something a little more complicated. I'll try to do a double up martingale progression and see what happens when you try to use a betting system to get ahead.